Good morning, dear children. Welcome back to the class. So today we are going to do revision of chapter numbers. Okay. So as we have finished the revision of your subtraction and addition, children, so go through it, and if you find any difficulty, you can ask me. Also go through the properties, children. So let's start in chapter numbers, children. Today we are going to do revision of these two topics, that is reading and writing numerals and number names up to 999. How to read, write, and how to write the numerals and the number names up to 999, which we have already done, isn't it? Today we will do the revision of this topic. Next, place values, face values, and expanded forms of numbers. So these two topics, children, we are going to do in today's class. So everyone take out your maths copy, draw a margin, write today's date, revision, and let's start the class, children. So children, let's start with our first question, fill in the blanks. You can note down these questions, children, and try to do yourself first. And let's discuss the answers now. First, A, the smallest two-digit number is. Now you know, children, that one-digit number starts from 0 and ends at 9. Isn't it? From 0 to 9 are your one-digit numbers. So two-digit number starts from 10. Two-digit number starts from 10 and ends at 99. So we can say that 10 is the smallest two-digit number and 99 is the largest two-digit number, isn't it? So what is the question? The smallest two-digit number is. So what will be the answer? 10. Okay. Let's do the next. B, the largest three-digit number is. Now children, you know up to 99 is your two-digit number. So three-digit number starts from 100 and ends at 999. Okay. So we can say that 100 is the smallest three-digit number and 999 is the largest three-digit number. Now what question is asking? The largest three-digit number is. So what will be the answer? 999. Okay. Next, C. Now children, 10 tens is equal to dash hundreds. 10 tens will make, if there are 10 tens, children, will make how many hundreds? Suppose this one block, children, is of 100 tens. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This one block is of tens, isn't it? If you make this type of tens, children, now that if you count 10, 10, 10, what will you get? How many hundreds will you get, children? Let's give you one more example. Let's take one finger as tens. If you count one as tens, children, then 10, 10, 10, 10, 10. So if you count 10 times tens, children, what will you get? 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. Isn't it? So 10 tens, this type of 10 tens, children, will make your 100. That is, what will we write? 100. It will make 100. Is it clear to everyone? Next, E. Sorry. 100. Next, 40 tens is equal to dash hundreds. So children, 40 tens will make how many hundreds if there are 40 tens? Like this is tens. I told you 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This is one block of tens, children. If there are 40 tens, if you count 10, 10, 10, so what will you get? If children, 10 tens makes 100, then 40 tens will make how many hundreds? 400. Clear? So what will be the answer? 400. Clear? Next is E. 806 is equal to 800 plus dash plus 6. Now children, this is what? This is your expanded form. You know when we expand a number, children, we put which sign? We put plus sign and we expand according to their place value. So 6 is in 1's place. So what is the value? 6. 0 is in 10's place, children. So what will be the value of 0? You know, the value of 0 will remain 0. So what will come here? 0. Clear? Next, the expanded form of the... So first is place value. Place value of 9. So children, 9 is in which place? 9 is in hundreds place, isn't it? Ones, tens, hundred. 9 is in hundreds place. So what will be the place value of 9? 900. So what is the answer? 900. Clear? And next, it is asked to find the face value. So what will be the face value of 9? Face value of 9. So you know, children, face value means the number itself. We are finding the face value of 9. That means 9 itself is the face value. So what is the answer? 9. Clear? Place value and face value. Face value is what, children? The number itself. If it is asked to find the face value of 3, you will say 3 is the face value. Okay? Then 6. 6 is the face value. Now, if it is asked, children, what is the place value of 3? 3 is in which place? 10th place, isn't it? So, what will be the place value? 30. Clear? So, 6 is in 1's place, children. So, 6 remains 6. Am I clear to everyone, children? You can do this. Note down in your copy. Let's do the next question. Let's do the third question, children. Write the expanded form of the number shown by the following blocks. Also write its number name. So children, we are going to find the expanded form and we are also going to write the number name. Clear? You can see these blocks, children, and you know what are the values of these blocks, isn't it? This comes under which place of the place value chart. So children, you know that this is in hundreds place, isn't it? This one block is 100. One block is 100. That comes in ones, hundreds place. This is tens, isn't it? So this comes in tens place, 110. That means what is the place value? 10. How many ones are here, children? 4 ones, isn't it? So what number are you getting after adding all this? 100 plus 10, 110 plus 4, you are getting. If you put it in the place value chart, children, ones, tens, 100. So one, this is in hundreds place, this is in tens place, and this is in ones place. So what number are you getting, children? 114. So the number is 114. Now we have to expand. This one is in which place, children? Hundreds place. So what is the place value? 100. Plus this one block is in which place, children? Tens place. So what is the place value? 10. There are how many ones? 4 ones. So what is the place value? 4. So we got the expanded form of the number 114. Clear? Now we have to write the number name. So let's write the number name. What will be the number name of 114, children? So we'll write in spelling 114. F-O-U-R. A T double E N 14. Clear? So you can note down this in a copy, children. So children, let's do the last question. Seema has one note of rupees 100 and one note of rupees 10. How much money does she have in all? Write amount in words. So how much money does she have in all? What we are going to do? Plus, the word in all is there, so we are going to do addition. Next, the answer which we are going to get after addition, children, we are going to write in words. Okay, so let's do. So for what we are going to write, one note of rupees 100 makes 100 rupees, isn't it? Then one note of rupees 10 makes 10 rupees, isn't it? So children, now how much money does she have in all? We are going to do addition. Total money, rupees 100 plus rupees 10. Don't forget to give this sign, children. So rupees 100 plus rupees 10 makes rupees 110. So now we are going to write this in words. 110 rupees. What we are going to write? 110 rupees. You can note down this in a copy, children. So that's all for today. You practice these questions at home, and if you find any difficulty, you can ask me. Thank you so much.